Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. Today we're going to be replacing the input shaft seals on our 2004 Yamaha F225. Now previously we had already done the replacement of the water pump, and I noticed one of the seals was damaged. So we're going to go back in and get those seals replaced. But before we get started, let's step over to the table and look at the parts and the tools we're going to need to pull this off. There is no kit for this particular project, so you'll need to buy the parts individually, or you can click that link in the description below where we already have a shopping cart ready to go for everything that we used in this video. Now, if your drive is in decent shape, you should need nothing more than a screwdriver to carefully pry the housing up. Given the condition of ours and the level of corrosion, we went ahead and picked up a puller from our friends over at Marine Tech. Really high-end stainless unit, and this should get the job done. So, now that we've got our specialty tools together, let's go over there and get this done. As you can see, we've already removed the lower unit. If you need a little help getting this off, why don't you refer back to our water pump video and I'll walk you through the process. Basically, you just have these four bolts that are from the bottom, but you've got one hidden under the trim tab, so make sure you don't miss that one. So, now that we've got it out, let's go ahead and take our housing back off, and that will expose the seals that are below. So gently pry up on this cover. Now we can just lift it off. You cut a couple of O-rings that have to go back in. There she goes. Now, as I talked about on the impeller video, you actually have to take off this locking collar before you can get to that nylon spacer that's below. Being nylon, it is somewhat fragile. So what I'm doing is prying down against a socket back and forth until I get it to release. Takes a little bit of patience, but make sure you don't get under the nylon, otherwise you'll snap it. There it is. Now you can see where the spacer is actually split, so you can just open it up a tick and then slide it up. Next, what you have is a flat washer, and then what they call a wave washer, and then another flat washer down at the bottom. So you'll have three of those all together. Next, we can go ahead and pull up the impeller itself. Remove the key. Hopefully yours won't be as difficult as that one. We can get our wear plate and the gasket out. Now with all that out of the way, we can take a look at that seal that I'd noticed. So there's supposed to be a metal retaining ring that goes around this part of the seal. When we had taken this apart before, I noticed that there were just pieces of it left up on top. So obviously it's disintegrated. So next, let's go ahead and get those four bolts out. And the challenging part is actually going to be to remove this housing out, which has the two seals inside of it. So as predicted, this is corroded in place and you've got basically a zero chance of removing it with a screwdriver. The only thing you're going to accomplish is breaking the housing and or that lower unit edge right there. So as predicted, we're going to be going to our special tool from our friends over at Marine Tech. See if we can get this thing to come out of there. What I'm attempting to do now is just to get this to rotate, to break it loose inside of the housing, because it's obviously going to have to be replaced. The pitting is so severe where the seals were, I don't see a way to clean it up and reuse it. So yes, am I damaging it? Well, yes, because we're going to replace it. But I don't see any other way around it at this point. All right, let's see if this thing pops loose. There we are. Unbelievable. Well, she's out. Now, if you watched one of our earlier videos where I did the prop shaft seals on this particular lower end, it was obvious that there's bearing damage inside of that housing. It's obvious again that there's bearing damage on this one as well. Now, we're going to save that one for another video. So the purpose of this video is just to show you how to pull the housing. Hopefully yours wasn't that tough. And we're going to go ahead and replace the seals in a new housing, put it back together. We're going to deal with all the bearing issues as a whole on another video. But today we're just concentrating on the seals. But believe me, we're going to go back because even with new seals, bottom and top, this lower unit is nowhere near being usable on the bottom end of a boat. So we've got our new housing, and it would be a crying shame to put it in something so dirty. So what we're going to do right now, spend a little bit of time getting this cleaned back up, and then I'll walk you through putting it back together. All right, at this point, once you've got things cleaned up, you want to feel around and look, make sure this isn't pitted to the point it's not going to seal up again. This one actually, believe it or not, actually feels pretty good through here. I don't see any pitting. I don't feel anything. It cleaned up reasonably well. We have our new housing. We've got our seals. We've got our O-ring. But we also have a new needle bearing that needs to be pushed into the housing. So let's get that done first. The trick here is you want to get this edge to go below this point by in between 4.25 to 4.75 millimeters depth. It's right there. Okay, we're flush at this point, and now we just need to set it down. We're aiming for 4.5 millimeters. Getting close. Let's take a look at that and see where it is. Folks, I think we've nailed it. That is right on 4.5, so we're going to go with that. So our two seals, they're going to end up being installed like this, stacked on top of each other. Both bottom edges are facing in at this point, and this upper edge is going to be roughly a half a millimeter down below the edge of the housing. So that's what we're aiming for. When you're picking out a driver to do this, make sure that you're actually driving more toward the outer edge of the seal itself. Otherwise, you're just going to drive it straight through and destroy it. All right, we almost have it set up. Let's go ahead and get our O-ring in place. Now we've got it put together. So before we actually install it, we want to pack the two seals with grease. We want to oil our bearing and then put a light coat of grease around this O-ring to where it presses into the housing easier. What you're doing here is actually filling the cavity between the two seals. Now, let's go ahead and get that O-ring on the outside. Just for kicks, go ahead and put a light coat on all the metal surfaces. So when the next time comes around, hopefully this will cut down on how much corrosion is going to happen. You have a better chance of getting it to pull free. So this is set up and ready to go. Let's get it reinstalled. We've got our housing ready to go. We just put it over the input shaft, and you want this galleyway pointing toward the front. There it is. Yamaha recommends that you use a little bit of Loctite on these bolts, so I'm going to go with the blue, and then we'll get those tightened down. Last piece we have is just this upper cover. Well, all right, guys, that pretty much wraps this one up. Only thing I have to do now is just remount the water pump and then reinstall the lower unit. Now, if you need help doing that, why don't you reference our videos that show you how to get that covered. Listen, if you need any parts for your boat, why don't you come see us at boats.net and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. Hey, if you like what you see, why don't you go ahead and hit that subscribe button? That way you can keep up with whatever I'm working on next. Listen, we just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Have a great day.